يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Or you who believe, fear Allah with the taqwa that He is deserving of and do not die except as Muslims. The jinn, ayyul ikhwa, from the reasons why they will enter the person, whether that is male or female, there are reasons from them. And the jinn, ayyul ikhwa, when they enter, then that is only with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But from the reasons why they may enter, first and foremostly, that the jinn, whether that is a male or female from the jinn, that they may have a desire, shahwa, desire, or yani feel passionate about a human being, this ishq that they may have for a human being, that they become attracted to a human being. And that is why when a person, he has been commanded that when he yani is in those places of seclusion or wherever he may be, where he may take off his clothes or her clothes, he or she makes the dua. And that a person says Bismillah. For the jinn, it is possible for them that they get attracted, and they are attracted to a person. That a person, when he enters the bathroom, and when he takes off his clothes, and he makes the dua, Bismillah, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubathi wal-khaba'ith. O Allah, I seek refuge in you from the khubath, from the male jinn, the shayateen from the male jinn, and the shayateen from the female jinn. And that a person protects himself in these places, and that a person covers himself whenever he is able, except for those times when it is necessary for him to be in a state of nakedness. And that is why the Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned, and from the reasons also that the jinn may enter a human being, is that a person, he may harm someone from the jinn. And so the Prophet ﷺ, he said, إِنَّ هَذِهِ الْحُشُوشِ مُحْتَضَرَةِ. Indeed, these trees, and in these places where in those times they used to go to relieve themselves, when they used to go to relieve themselves, muhtadara, they are attended to, by the jinn. And the jinn, this is where they reside, these places. And so if one of you, he goes there and he intends to relieve himself, and let him say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith. And that a person, as the scholars they mention, that a person doesn't urinate under the trees and by the trees. For indeed, from the means and ways that a jinn enters a human being is that a person may harm the jinn without realizing. And likewise, as the scholars they mention, throwing hot water at a person, when he throws hot water, he should say Bismillah. But indeed, the jinn, they take revenge. وَيَكْثُرْ فِيهِمْ الْجَهْلِ وَالظُّلْمِ. As the scholars they mention, the jinn, that which is great amongst them as a characteristic is ignorance and dhulm. They oppress. And that is another reason. Sometimes the jinn may enter due to dhulm, just outright oppression, due to no reason. That the jinn, he's an evil doer, an evil jinn, just like we have evil men amongst us. And so this is another reason why the jinn may enter a human being. Likewise, al-ayn, the evil eye amongst men. Al-ayn haqq, that evil eye is real. As the Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned, and when a person, he has the evil eye, jealousy towards his brother, behind every evil eye and with every evil eye and jealous eye, there is a jinn. There is a devil from the jinn who follows that eye. And due to this person resembling shaitan in him, being jealous of this blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed his brother with. And that he wants to see that blessing be removed from him. Likewise, from the reasons why the jinn may enter a human being is due to sihr, magic, due to those men who learn magic and work and deal with the jinn. And they send the jinn to those who they want to afflict. And so they break up marriages and they break up families. And it is not allowed. Those who practice magic, this is kufr. And it is not allowed for us to go to them. Nor is it allowed for us to repel magic with magic. Or to remove the jinn by utilizing and using the jinn also. And this is haram. And then there are those times, ayyul ikhwa, wherein it makes a person more vulnerable and liable. Yani more easier that the jinn yani affect him and afflict him. From them is that a person, yani he's in that state of severe anger, severe fear, that a person is in severe fear. And likewise, O Muslim, it is not for you to fear the jinn. That you shouldn't fear the jinn. This extreme fear is a means for the jinn to enter the human being. Likewise, from those times that make a person more liable to the jinn entering him is when he is completely submissive to his desires. And he follows his desires in every way, as though he has made sujood to his desires. And when he's in a state of complete heedlessness, far from Islam, far from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Na'am. As for the cures and preventions, ayyul ikhwa, then first and foremost, the Al-Quran. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And we reveal in this Quran that which is a shifa, a cure, and a mercy for the believers. The Quran, ayyul ikhwa. And likewise, the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغٌ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. And if a whisper from shaitan comes to you, then seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. That a person, he recites the Qur'an in general, all of it. And then more specifically, Al-Surah Al-Baqarah, within the home. And then Ayatul Kursi. And then Surah Al-Ikhlas, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدْ. And likewise, the Mu'awwadhatayn, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ وَقُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. Naam, and likewise, those du'as and adhkar that have come in the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And it is better for a person that he recites upon himself, the one afflicted by the jinn. And likewise, those who are not afflicted by the jinn, to prevent the jinn from afflicting them. It is better for the person, the one who is afflicted by the jinn, that he recites upon himself. And indeed, this is ibadah, and he is more knowledgeable of how he is in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as opposed to others making ruqya and reciting upon him. But although this is still allowed, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to the Sahaba, when one of the Sahaba, one who was in the presence of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he was bitten by a scorpion and he became affected by the jinn, and the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, فَمَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ مِنْكُمْ أَنْ يَنْفَعَ أَخَاءَ فَلْيَفْعَلْ. Whoever amongst you is able to help his brother, then let him help. نَعْمُ.